Okay, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I'm going to start a new thing on this part of my channel, and it'll be a cooking part. What you're seeing here is it's the pork loin center cut chops, and I paid $3.76 a pound. This is $1.29 per pound, and total price was $4.85. So what I'm going to do today is I am going to make this in the shape of the state of Arkansas. So that is what I'm going to do. And I'm going to start doing this with a lot of the stuff I have. I've got a chicken breast and I've got that, and I'll start doing some more stuff. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to figure out which one of these I can use for the state of Arkansas. So what I'm going to do is try to figure out which one would be the best. I'd say this one right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it in the shape of Arkansas. Now I'm trying to figure out, okay, with this will probably be the Mississippi River. And this will be, let's see here, trying to think, I'll cut this, let's see here, and I'll cut this just in the shape of Arkansas. And it's going to be kind of going like this. Or let's see here, like this. I think. Cut this now. Yeah, I got that. And now, see, I learned how to do this. It was from the Chew. So actually, they didn't do exactly what I'm doing, but they were doing something similar. But as you can see, that's going to be like that. Now I'm going to put this and this is pork, and I'm going to cut this the way that I'm going to make the steak. Yeah, it's just my phone. So this is going to be just like the state, or at least I'm going to try. And it kind of looks more like the state of Arizona, probably. But I'm going to try my best to make it just like the steak. So, just got to put it in like so. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the pictures I've done in the past and try to get the steak almost to that same kind of thing. Now, what I'll do is I'll put it like that, and I am going to put that in the frying pan here, and I'm gonna be right back. But anyway, y'all, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I will talk to y'all. Okay, y'all, I'm back. And, got to cut this part out. So what I'm going to do is I am going to cut this part. Sounds like my neighbor's doing some weed eating. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I know it's not the best state, but I'm trying my best. But if you look at that, you see, it kind of looks like it because of the way that it's cut. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put this in there, and then I'm going to start cooking it. So, I haven't used my stove in a long time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this I'm going to get this to where I put it in there, and I'll be right back. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this canola oil that I'm going to put on. And I'm going to use this far right front, and I'm going to put it on in, say, 6. And what I'm doing is I'm going to put this and spray it with canola oil. Now I'm going to take my steak here, and before I do that, I'm going to cut it in just a little more. And then I should be able to get in now. going to use every part of this. Because I don't like to waste food. So, that's what it looks like right there. And it's, like I said, it's not the best in the state. But I'll start experimenting some more. But that is what I've got. Now, since I've got that cooking, and I'm going to put that on like so, so you all can see that while I get some more stuff. I am going to season it. So I'm going to take some onion powder, put that on. It's if it'll come off here. I don't know. It's like it's not been used in a while. Okay. Well, let's just use some garlic powder then. So I'm going to use some garlic powder. And now I'm going to use some chopped onions. Since I'm trying to use a low-salt diet, I'm only going to use only a few parts of salt. But I'm going to use, instead of salt, I'm going to use Mrs. Dash. And then, I don't know, maybe some pickling spice? Nah, I'm not going to use pickling spice. Maybe use some black pepper. And now, I'm going to cook it for a little bit. As you can see, it's the state, and it looks like the state of Arkansas. Now, like I said, I got this idea from the Chew, and I'm going to probably put this on my channel so you all can see that, and then what I'm going to do is I'll start on making more stuff. But right now, while that's cooking, I'm starting to wonder what else I can do. I'm thinking that I want to do either Texas or Louisiana next. And see what happens with that. And this will be for all the people that live in Texas. And I'll start doing that with probably chicken breast. And that's what I'm going to do. For right now, I'm going to try to figure out what other state I can do with pork. And if I can do something with pork, the other state, but since this state, Arkansas, has their mascot, that is a Razorback, it is none other than pork. So I'm going to do that, and it's going to kind of get it to where it's all good here. So, but, yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and lift it and do it that way. Now, I'm going to season it again so you all can see that, but that's my pork. So I'm going to do a little more seasoning, and then we will go from there. So you all can see that. And I'm going to put some more Mrs. Dash and put that on. And then I'll put on some chopped onions. And since I really don't have a lot of barbecue sauce or anything like that, I'll do something different this time. But, let's see here. Got ground cinnamon. Yeah, I don't need ground cinnamon. Okay, garlic powder. So, I will cook the state of Arkansas. And it's amazing how pork can keep its shape. It really is. So, I am going to do a little more stuff. Yeah, put in some more canola oil. Because what I did is I sprayed it. And now, I want to put some more canola oil in there. And I'm going to flip it yet again. How easy that seems to be. And granted, it's not the best Mississippi River, but I might do the state of Arkansas with chicken too, because you know, they say that Arkansas does make chicken. So now I think that this other one, no, I'm just trying to figure out what I should use for that. But I think this would be kind of neat. I'm still trying to figure out if I should do an Oklahoma one, which shouldn't be that hard. Matter of fact, I think I'll do it in Arkansas and Oklahoma. So, while that is cooking, I'm going to pull that away, and I'm going to do the state of Oklahoma. And let's see, since I have this, which is right here, which is that borderline there of Arkansas, now since Oklahoma kind of goes out here, and then now let's see here, and just cut this off. This is a fat. Now, since Oklahoma kind of goes up like this, and then it goes out, it's got the panhandle. What I'm going to do is, this is a short Oklahoma, but I figure, you know what, I bet Heartland Dual Sport would love this. So this is in honor of even my trip to Oklahoma and also to Heartland Dual Sport. So, as you can see, that's almost ready to be put in here. So, okay, now I'm going to take this. And I'm going to put this in here. Now, as you can see, Arkansas is almost done. That kind of sounds weird. And Oklahoma is just in there. So, Now I'm going to kind of do a little artwork here. Just kind of get it going. Now, but the same kind of thing. I'm going to put that. I'm going to put some garlic powder chopped onion. And maybe some black pepper that I'll put it on Arkansas and Oklahoma. And y'all can see that. And it looks like Arkansas is almost ready to eat. That sounds weird. So now I'm gonna try to cut this while it's still in the frying pan. I have some fat, and I guess what I'll do, since nothing goes to waste, now my state of Arkansas is falling apart. Now, take the state of Oklahoma. I'm just going to move it around. And season it again. Garlic powder. Chopped onions. And a little bit of pepper. Now, who says you can't eat your steak, huh? Well, eventually I'll get to where I'm good at this. But that's what I'm gonna do now. Now I will get the plate ready, and then eat it. And then we'll see what happens. Now, I'm going to see if how well this is. It looks like it's pretty well Okay, y'all. Arkansas tastes pretty good. So, that's what I've got. Now I'm just gonna, I'm gonna put it on my plate. And as you can see, okay, and that's Arkansas. Now, I'm going to finish cooking Oklahoma. God, that sounds weird. But, that's what I've got. And, I wanted to show you what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to start cooking these steaks. And I get some time off for work, which is today, so anyway, y'all, now I'm gonna bring Oklahoma. Okay, y'all, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I am spreading this shredded cheese all over. Kind of looks yummy, huh? Over the state of Arkansas and the state of Oklahoma. So, anyway, since I like to torture myself, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put habanero and pepper jack. So, I got to make sure that I keep this out of my cat's reach because they will eat anything. They will eat anything. So, especially my youngest, she will eat anything that is on this counter. So, now, I'm going to taste it. So you all can see what it looks like. That is definitely good. That is definitely good, y'all. So anyway, I'm going to finish eating this masterpiece, and I'll talk to you in my next vlog. Anyway, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I'll talk to you all later. And I'm good to go. So, that's what I got for y'all today. Anyway, I'm going to take put some of this stuff on. Hot jalapeno, habanero, jack and habanero and jack and cheese. So, because I like habanero, believe it or not. So, I'm going to turn off the oven there. Okay. I'm going to have to do some more stuff. I guess I'm going to have to try and get my hands dry. Because I can't open this. Alright, y'all. I will be back.